Yeah, I come back in. They blocked that one. Yeah. Yeah, come on back in. Yeah, they blocked that one. They kicked me off that one. So, yeah. Yeah, Javon, they was mad. Shit, Facebook did something they rather do, which is block me for playing a song. And I wasn't even playing a video. I was just playing a regular song. Shit. What's up, Katrilla? Man, let's continue on with the lecture. Y'all come on back in. So now, since they blocked me for love and affection, I ain't gonna play it no more. Shit, let's finish up. Then now we got to talk about the dark side of love. What is heartbreak? It's the feeling you experience when that chemical bond you have with your companion breaks in whatever shape, form, or fashion. So we got to talk about the dark side of it. Like sometimes, you know, that shit just fall apart. Yeah, it's a real life. These things go down. What's up, Joanna? These things go down, right? So that's what heartbreak is. It is the drawback feelings that you experience when that chemical bond you had with your companion breaks in whatever shape, form, or fashion. Now, what is hate? Hate is repulsion, which is dark side of love. It's usually what you experience for a while after that bond breaks. You know, you just don't want to have nothing to do with love. You're just repelling the energy, giving yourself time to heal, relax, and regenerate from the energy. You see what I'm saying? So, Georgia, what's up, Sharonda? And the reason why this happens is because, just like the body is a technology. So, when something breaks in a machine, what happens? It needs time to repair itself. So that's what you're experiencing when, you know, your buns break as companions. So now. A few questions that a lot of people ask me, why is love so hard to find on the third dimension? The answer is it is because love has been compromised by these archons down here. That's why most empaths run to narcissists more than anybody else on the planet. Narcissists are emotional archons. They have come to vamp the empath's energy. You know, they emotional agents. You see what I'm saying? That's come to vamp the empath or the star child or star seed's energy. Why do they do this? They do this because the heart chakra has the most energy out of all the chakras due to the soul being within the heart. You see what I'm saying? It's a vortex, a black hole within your heart chakra that you can go to and you pour it in to your soul. You see what I'm saying? Your soul realm, your soul dimension, like they showed you in Avatar. She always goes into what? Her heart chakra. And she always goes through what? A black hole. And when she goes through that black hole, which is nothing but a portal, she sees who? She sees a giant. She goes into her own personal melanin dimension. And she sees a what? A giant deity version of herself. And she's holding what? Her divine spark, which is her soul. You see what I'm saying? That's why they have so many narcissists down here. Narcissists are emotional archons. That's what they are. Emotional archons. They have chosen, or they didn't choose, they just were created. A lot of them are clones and droids and shit. So they were created to vamp you. You know, they were created to suck up your energy, you know, from you, so that you could be a hollowed out husk. So you won't have the power, the light, the glow. To emanate down here, to emanate to other people so that they can awaken themselves, because your light actually touches other people and actually helps them awaken to who they are, because your soul activates your soul, connects to the soul of another person through quantum entanglement. So when you vibrate on a certain frequency and they vibrate on a certain frequency, y'all souls connect. When this quantum entanglement happens, then, like they said, namaste, or the soul in me, or the God in me recognizes the God in you, and vice versa. That's what you're experiencing. Well, the purpose of a narcissist or an emotional archon is to keep you so low vibrational, to drain you so much, to vamp you so much to where you cannot generate enough light, enough frequency, enough energy to be on a level where you can find others like yourself, other star seeds like yourself. That's what their agenda is. And because the earthlings are such an emotional species, that's probably the deadliest arena out of the three. You know, you got physical archons, you got spiritual archons, and then you even got technological archons. But nothing is as deadly down here as the emotional archons, or what y'all call the narcissists, because earthlings have a natural tendency to fall in love, especially empaths. They have a natural, well, actually a supernatural tendency to fall and be in love. You see what I'm saying? With other people, for companionship. You know, they have a natural tendency for that. So, their way of coming after motherfuckers is to send these narcissists. And notice, these narcissists don't fuck with nobody but empaths. Peep game. They literally seek out and hunt down empaths. They don't fuck with nobody else on this plane but people that they can drain. If you don't believe me, when the motherfucker get through vamping you and you the empath get away from the motherfuckers, just go look on their Facebook page and see what they're doing. And you're going to see that they done went and found another empath to drain. They don't fuck with nobody but empaths. See what I'm saying? They don't fuck with nobody but empaths on this plane. They don't date no other beings on the planet. An empath, what is an empath? An empath is a demigod, to be simple. An elder soul who has already come back with the supernatural codes to change the world. You just need a little bit more knowledge, a little bit more esoteric knowledge, metaphysics, gnosis, cold science, to upgrade yourself to full God and Goddess status. That's all you need. And they know this. So, to stop you, one of the ways to stop you from realizing this is to bring in these emotional archons. See what I'm saying? To vamp your heart chakra so that you won't even have the energy to find this information. You see what I'm saying? That's why you feel 5 years older, 10 years older when you're in relationships with these motherfuckers, because they're sucking all your life force. So you feel older. But as soon as you get away from the motherfuckers, you feel 5 or 10 years younger. That's because you got your life force back. You regenerated yourself now. That's what you got going on with this love energy. You see what I'm saying? With these narcissists, that's emotional warfare. A lot of people don't talk about the emotional warfare like they should. And because the emotional warfare on Earth is the deadliest warfare here. They know that physically, they can keep you at a job and money and whatever, but they know you still have a certain level of detachment from that shit. You know, it's just money. You know, I pay my bills, and after that, it's cool. So they know that warfare there has limitations. They also know spiritual warfare. If you already on a spiritual level, you already hard to deal with anyway, because you know who the fuck you are. So they get you in the middle ground. They get you somewhere in between, which is the emotional realm. You see what I'm saying? The emotional paradigm. That's the deadliest paradigm on this planet, because that's the in between paradigm from the physical and the spiritual. So they got. That's why the heart chakra is the middle chakra. That's where they get you the most. Like they shows you in Norse mythology, Ragnarok happens in the heart chakra. I've been telling people that for years. The old gods, or should I say, the Asir gods versus the giants, which are the old gods, they all go to war in the heart chakra. That war is happening in your heart chakra. You see what I'm saying? So when that goes down, by the time you get to the spiritual plane, you already know what the fuck going on. You already about that life. So to keep you from getting to that level, what do? They specialize in sending narcissists after empaths. They call them handlers. Now you call them whatever the fuck you want to. Handlers, walk-ins, whatever. Most of them are narcissists. You know, so that's the deadliest group of beings on here. And how many, hell, you know how many fucking narcissists have killed empaths? You know? And if a narcissist cannot find an empath, they will self-destruct. They will, the reason why they got to find empaths to feed off of, because they will self-destruct and commit suicide. That's why. That's why. Because the arcane energy cannot sustain itself by itself, because it will feed on itself and it will consume itself. You see what I'm saying? So they have to find somebody to feed off of. The most powerful people on the planet are empaths. You know, elder souls. So they got to do this. They got to seek you out and vamp you. And if you get away from them, then and they're going to get better at it just like anybody else. Just like an empath gets better at being an empath, a narcissist gets better at being a narcissist. So empath develop their abilities in a starseed type of way. Narcissists develop their abilities in the arcane way. So their level of vampirism. Have you ever met a high narcissist or a supreme narcissist that just walking into the environment? You ain't even in a relationship with them. Just being their energy field, just fucking snatch some of your energy. You see what I'm saying? Just walking by the motherfuckers in the store, snatch your energy. See what I'm saying? That's how vampiric they have become. They have become living, breathing, emotional vampires. Those are what you call high archons. They've become so archonic on the physical plane due to vamping people that they shit so strong now that they'll vamp you just from being in the environment. See what I'm saying? Just from being in the motherfucking environment. This is what you got going on here. This is what you're dealing with. So, yes, you have to protect your energy. You have to protect your force, because you have these motherfuckers out here. And they are all levels. You got master fucking narcissists around here who just walk into their energy field will suck up your life force. They can walk into a Walmart and suck up everybody's energy if they don't know. Suck up everybody's energy in the room if that person doesn't know how to protect themselves. Peep game. And usually those are the motherfuckers who, if you ever notice, narcissists are very, very popular. This is why they popular. Because when they walk in the room, they sucking up all your energy, and you are resonating with your energy that they're sucking up into them. That's why narcissists are so fucking popular. You see what I'm saying? You try to figure out why this crazy motherfucker is so goddamn popular. It's because narcissists, when they walk into a room, they suck up the energy. And when they suck up the energy, you are resonating with your own energy that they're sucking up. Going into them. You see what I'm saying? You are resonating with that part of yourself that they've stolen from you. This is what you got going on here. So that's what emotional warfare is. That's what the true warfare is. It is all about destroying your heart chakra before you find yourself esoterically and rise up to full God status. That's what narcissism is. That's why narcissists go out and fuck up as many empaths as they possibly can. You don't believe me. Like I said, a lot of y'all dealt with narcissists. Hell, a lot of y'all still Facebook friends with the motherfuckers. Go to their page right now. I guarantee you they're in a relationship with another empath. Matter of fact, track their relationships. You can read these motherfuckers now. Track their relationships. Usually they keep a list of their victims. You know, their list, their catalog of victims is their resume, right? So they keep a catalog of their victims who they've drained over the years. I guarantee you, you go and look at every woman or man who they have vamped over the years, I guarantee you the motherfuckers is empaths. Not one of the persons is a regular person. Not one of those, or if they are regular people, they sidekicks. They narcissists in training. you know, you got them too. You got narcissistic apprentices, vampiric apprentices as well. So you don't believe me, go research the motherfuckers, go look at their victims and see who all they date, and y'all guarantee you they are dating number fucking empaths draining them. Peep game. And it, like I said, they do got a regular person. Their regular person is a narcissist in training. They are learning the ropes of to become a narcissistic archon. You see what I'm saying? A narcissistic vampire. So now let us continue here. So, a lot of people ask me, how do you find love? You find love by finding yourself. Love is already inside you, like I told y'all in part one. I had to get that unblocked before I even release this lecture now. I'm about to get that on block, real talk. They block that motherfucking, like, in, like, 200 countries here. They be, like, 300 countries on in the world. So, yeah. Anyway, you find love by finding yourself, your true self, which is within you. So, and the more you tap into your heart chakra, the more love you will find. The more love you find, the more of a bliss state you will attain. The more of a bliss state you will attain, the more light you will generate. And so, yeah, and the more you will glow. So there you go. So that's it. That's emotional bioluminescence there. See what I'm saying? Emotional bioluminescence. So yeah, cause when you enter that bliss state, then your heart is full of light. You know, you got a toroidal heart field around you. So the more you enter that bliss state, the more light shines out into that toroidal heart field. And so you begin to bioluminate. Another reason why narcissists will come out of you, that they attracted to the light of your toroidal heart field, like moths to a flame or flies to a light or whatever. And they want their light. They want their light. They hungry for their light. Some of these motherfuckers eat your shine, like Dick Howard told us in Dr. Sleep. They don't run from it. The light doesn't bother them. Some of these motherfuckers eat that shit. That's dinner to them. Lunch and breakfast and dessert and shit. You feel me? So definitely. So you find love by finding yourself. So definitely. How do you find companionship? Which is the next question. When you find yourself, you automatically attract someone that is on your level. Yes, when you tap into more and more of your love programs inside of you, if you want companionship, because a lot of motherfuckers don't even want companionship once they get a certain level of consciousness. They don't even care about it like that, you know, because they know that love has been rigged down here. You know, the emotional, they know like I know that that's why you see a lot of occultists who are single. They know like I know that shit, the emotional paradigm is the deadliest battlefield here. So why would you want to go back to the battlefield after you've already conquered your demons and already conquered your narcissists? See what I'm saying? Why would you want to go back to that? For real. So that's why you see a lot of occultists and spiritual people not in relationships, because they don't want to deal with that shit no more. Yeah, you know, most motherfuckers down here ain't vibrating on no 5D love or and higher. They're not vibrating that high. So that's why it's so hard to find companionship down here. Because who wants to go back to that battlefield? I mean, really, when that's the deadliest battlefield here? And that shit is hard to come back out of, by the way. You know how hard it is to wield a force with a broken heart? It's hard as hell. So who wants to go through that? Who wants to continue to break down their technology and rebuild it and have to take 6 months to a year to repair it? You see what I'm saying? Nobody wants to do that. Nobody wants to do that every fucking time, you know. And the more you repair it, the more exhausted the technology is. And now you got to take 5-10 years off a relationship. Now you 40 and don't want to have anything to do with nobody. You see what I'm saying? So yeah. So that's how this thing work. That's how this thing work. So now, when understanding that, that's why you don't see a lot of coaches in relationship. Now, the gray area is to how you vibrate. The more you attract someone high vibrational to you. You see what I'm saying? But the more you, the lower you vibrate, the more you attract lower vibration. And let me tell you, narcissists are vibrating on ELF frequencies, extra low frequencies. That's what archons vibrate on. You know, shit. So extra low frequency radio waves and all that shit, they will come after you. Like moths to a flame, because that's why star seeds can't afford to vibrate that low, because they can't wait for you to fall that far in your frequency. They waiting in the closet. When you vibrate that low, them niggas just pop up out of nowhere. You be like, where the fuck these niggas come from? Niggas come out of a portal. They come out of a portal just to see you. They come through the astral plane just to come find you and fuck you up, for the most part. So yeah, but the higher you vibrate, the more you find like-minded people. And what you're gonna come to find out, when you vibrate high enough, you don't even need to be in a relationship to generate love, because love ain't that hard. 5D and higher. When you're a star child, love ain't that hard. It's not that hard of energy. You know, especially when you find your star tribes and your soul family and everything, it's not really that hard to admit, you know, or receive, because your star family gonna give it back to you, unlike motherfuckers down there in hell on the battlefield. You know, shit, they love to fool you into thinking they gonna give you something back. Nah, let me tell you, love giving and not receive is love wasted. Like I always tell y'all. Love giving and not receive is love wasted. So they love wasting your love and your fucking time. You know, they love sucking up the light from your heart chakra. They love that shit. See, you see what I'm saying? So yeah. You know who they are now. Shit, you pretty much been doing this along. You pretty much been doing this on the planet long enough to know. That's why. Anybody who is so-called of the light or star child, you know, catch hell down here. That's why love and light, you need more than love and light down here. These niggas is fucking crazy. You need chaos. You need magic. You need whatever. It's whatever down here. You in hell. Who obey the rules in hell? You got to be an outlaw star. You see what I'm saying? You got to be an outlaw soul. You feel me? So you got to be an outlaw down here. Shit, that's the only way you're going to survive. You know, they got this little popular anime called Outlaw Star. That's the only way they survive around here. It was actually the Outlaw Star's name of a ship, which was named Macabre, that they all traveled in. And it was the baddest ship in fucking the galaxy. So they basically tell you, you got to be an Outlaw Star down here if you want to survive this hellacious realm. So yeah. So there y'all go. So now, let's get into the good stuff. I have a love activation spell. You know, that I wrote for y'all. So y'all can tap into this. Now, let's get it. In your mind's eye, imagine yourselves in the forest, sitting on a bench, enjoying nature. Then the guy Oshun walks up to you to teach you how to summon love within yourself. So, yes, you can summon love at will. She tells you to focus on generating pink light. Why pink light? Pink light is the ray of divine love. From the bottom of your feet to the top of your head, you should then begin to feel a warm starburst feeling erupt out of your heart chakra. This light emission will be in the colors of green, pink, gold, and white. Oshun then tells you, whenever you are feeling love lost or exhausted in the heart chakra, you can channel this energy and enter this state known as Anjin. That's what the Asians call it, Anjin, A-N-J-I-N, which is a state of supreme love. To heal yourself and regenerate your heart force and heart space. Now, I got a picture of Oshun and the thymus chakra. Let me get that for y'all. Here we go. That's the heart, that's the thymus chakra, the upper heart. And here go Oshun. Orishan goddess of love, or lower goddess of love in the Haitian paradigm. Love and woe. So yeah, there y'all go. So that's a love activation spell. In conclusion, love is you, and you are it. So no one or nothing can take away your love, because your love is your own. That's basically what it is. Love is you, and you are it. So no one or nothing can take away your love, because your love is your own. Always remember that. Don't ever let them tell you otherwise. So yeah, that pretty much wraps it up. I end this lecture off with another song. Hopefully they don't block this one. Shit.
It's not what you said. It's how you said it. And all you say you love me when you know you'll regret it. It's not what we did, it's what we did on, and we've been losing time.
y'all go. Any questions before I get up out of here? I got working on unblocking part one now. So yeah, y'all might have to wait for this next to drop on YouTube. Yeah, till I get that unblocked. So yeah. Any questions? What technique can we kill the emotional vampires with? Emotional vampires are a little bit more difficult to deal with due to the fact that all they want to do is suck up your emotional energy. Right? So, really, you fuck up an emotional vampire by becoming hollow, by becoming neutral. They can't deal with balance or neutrality. You see what I'm saying? So they're going to try to do everything in their power to make you unbalanced. You see what I'm saying? So, because they can't handle that neutral energy. They can't feed off neutral energy. They're going to feed off positive or negative energy. So, they're going to try everything in their power to keep you in balance so that they have something to feed on. So, just being balanced and not letting them niggas get to you is a form of weaponry against them. I just said get away from the motherfuckers. But if they keep fucking with you, you can't tap into the force and start fucking them niggas up with your energy on the astral plane. Yeah, because they don't even look like humans on the astral plane. They look like vampires. They count Dracula around this bitch. Frost from Blade in this motherfucker. Oh, shit, that's what they look like that's what they look like on the astral plane, vampires. So you fuck them niggas up through the astral. They'll leave you alone. Once you murk their ass on the astral one good time, they're going to automatically break up with you on the physical because they know something wrong. They know there's something about you that's fucking deadly. So they're going to leave you alone. So, yeah. There you go. Any other questions? Y'all don't have no other questions. I'm Marvin Jones. Y'all put the word out. Y'all want to get the 100 sacred needle names, holler at me. It's for the 20, along with the 50 names of Marduk. Y'all want to check out my other occult lectures, hit me up at the Mail Now Order. If y'all just want to donate, y'all can support. Hit me. Yeah, you can support by hitting me up at MCJ Network. So, yeah. Like I said, this one's going to take a little while to get on YouTube. Cause I gotta get part one unblocked, hopefully. And I'm out. Peace.